Okay, you got a couple minutes there, Trevor, before you go down the aisle. Anything to say to the bride?
I love her.
How you feeling?
Good. Real good.
Don't cry.
What?
Don't cry.
I'm not.
Go ahead. Okay, I'm sorry.
So, Vidctoria, it's minutes before you walk down the aisle. How you feeling?
Very nervous.
Yeah. Anything you want to say to Trevor?
You're stuck with me.
I got one of you not tripping.
You know, the grooms.
We
know about.
We quite as often. Another one. Okay, good.
Say you will. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Kids too, all ages. On behalf of Trevor and Vidctoria, I welcome you all to this very special moment in their lives, their marriage ceremony. Trevor and Vidctoria, we are happy to be here with you today. Today is filled with a spirit of love, of hope, of excitement, and thanksgiving. As we gather on this beautiful spring day, almost summer, June 14th, 2014, at this beautiful outdoor setting, to witness two people in love to proclaim their marriage vows. Trevor Thomas Farr, and Vidctoria Ann Serafini, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands, who already joined, and declare your consent before God and before this faith community of friends and family gathered around you. Repeat after me then, Trevor. Vidctoria, just who knew his first names, okay? I, Trevor. Thank you, Gloria.
Vidctoria.
Glorious. It's in there. It's just, I can't avoid it. You know, the glory. Okay, let's start over. I, Trevor.
Take you, Vidctoria.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. And I, Vidctoria, take you, Trevor.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. You have declared your consent. May the Lord, in his goodness, strengthen your consent, and fill you both with blessings. A ring, or two rings, next. So, place this on your finger. Vidctoria. Take this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now you place this ring in this finger. Trevor, take this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you and bless these rings, which are symbols now of true faith in each other that you have. And I'll remind them of their love. At this time, because we're outdoors and we don't have the lighting of a candle, a unity candle, because it's hard to keep it burning in the outdoors. Instead, Trevor and Vidctoria are going to share a cup of wine. First, let me pray this little prayer for them. And after they taste the wine together, then they have a couple of moments to themselves, the very first moments having been married, a quiet, reflective time for them and all of us with them. This cup is a single cup, thank you, from which you both shall drink. It is a sign of your unity Although you are two distinct persons, each respecting the equal dignity of the other, you have chosen to unite your lives and seek your happiness together. Let this wine represent the spirit of your life together. By sharing this cup now, you show your desire to blend your spirits together even stronger. As together you share the wine from this cup, so may you, in enduring devotion to each other, draw contentment, comfort, and happiness from the cup of life. May you find life's joy heightened, its bitterness sweetened, and all things hallowed by true companionship and love. Take this cup now and drink from it in the spirit of loving you. Good time.
Start early.
May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead and through all the years. May happiness be your companion and your days together be good and long upon the earth. Amen. Congratulations to you two.
We did it.
Yes, we did.
I'll leave the mic there. I'll leave the mic there so you can hear this way. It now gives me a great deal of pleasure to pronounce these two people to be something, but first, by the authority vested in me as an ordained Catholic priest and also as a member of the Federation of Christian Ministers, I declare you, announce you to be husband and wife. And I want to introduce you now as Mr. and Mrs. for the first time, I guess. Yes?
Yes.
Trevor and Vidctoria Farr.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to try and move this narrative here for a while.
So I thought I should So, I will admit that it kind of sounds like what you'd be teaching Jace. So, this is what it is. My words of advice are, share everything, including bad partners. Play fair. Don't hit people. But the exact way you found them, clean up your own mess, including the scrap metal. Don't take things that are not yours. Say you're sorry when you hurt someone. Wash your hands before you eat and make sure you flush. I would also like to add a few other tidbits of advice. Always remember to say those three important little words. You're right, dear. If you're clever, you'll always have the last word. However, if you're very clever, you're never going to use it. And whenever you're wrong, just admit it. And whenever you're right, just be quiet. Just remember, a marriage is made in heaven, but the maintenance work is carried on out on earth. So we're all here today to celebrate everything that Victoria and Trevor have found in each other. A best friend, a lover, a teacher, a playmate, and a true partner for life. As you sit side by side through this roller coaster of life, remember to scream for the peace, hold hands through the dips, laugh through the loop-de-loops, and enjoy every twist and turn, for variety is better because you share it together. Separately, you are two special, very remarkable people, but together you are complete. May you both grow in a continuum of love, not forgetting the importance of understanding, forgiveness, and tolerance. Most importantly, may you always remember the love that brought you together today, a love so strong that you decided to share it forever in each other's company. In the fullness of your life together, may your love for each other continue to grow stronger. Today you are joined together as man and wife to commence that long and wonderful journey of growing both together. On behalf of my family, I would like to welcome Trevor and his entire family as we all look forward to getting to know you all much better. Finally, on behalf of the bride and groom, I would like to thank everyone for sharing their special day, as it is a true milestone. Now, it gives me immense pleasure to invite you all to stand and raise your glass in a toast to love, laughter, and happy ever after. And Trevor, a happy wife, make sure a happy wife.
How do you think the best man speech went?
It sucked.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you would change it, you mean, or what?
Would I change it? Yeah.
Yeah. Were you nervous?
I'm not the best public speaker there is.
Yeah. So you're not going to pursue a career in public speaking?
No.
No? Okay.
I'm going to hide in my kitchen and I'm going to like...
What do you think about his speech?
Pretty good.
No, his speech is not good.
We could use the ball.
I think he was a little bit inebriated. And maybe he should have practiced a few times. Or about.
Say something to the bride and groom.
He called the bride and groom. We're
yeah,
so happy for that.
Time, Jay. I don't know. Live the rest of your life happily ever after.
Thank you. Jace!
He gets a grocery cart and starts filling it full of pepper tarts. You gotta get the soft bake with
some noise for Mr. and Mrs. Bar! I hadn't told you all I love you.
just dance with you one more time before I start down the road of my brand new life. There's no way to thank you for all that you have done. No matter how old I get, I will always be your son. Thank you.
We got about 40 minutes left.